Bonjour tout le monde! Bienvenue à Legally Blonde! Hi everyone! It is, has been a very long time since I posted my last video. So I thought I'd make a cup of coffee. We could sit down and do a Life of Lyon series video today because recently, thanks to you guys, I've had interest in some more content and it was a good excuse for me to dig through the archives and see what I could find. And today's video will talk about the arrondissement de Lyon, the neighbourhoods of Lyon. So before we get started, I'll just recap that this channel was created back in 2019 when I was on exchange in Lyon during my second and final semester of university. And so all of the videos and footage that I am sharing with you today is old stuff that I took when I was there back in 2019. So this was in a pre-COVID world, but I can assure you that I have heard that Lyon is still as wonderful as ever. And I know that quite a few of you are planning to head there shortly for your own exchange. So that is really, really exciting. And I understand that recently a lot of you are now being able to travel again in Europe and quite a few of you are interested in Lyon. So this video today I thought could be quite helpful for those of you who just don't know where to live. And that was a really tricky thing for me to try and figure out when I was moving over to Lyon. I remember that at the time in my head I just said, no, I need to live by the university, I want to walk to university. But in the end I ended up on the other side of town in Vieux Lyon and the commute was absolutely fine. I jumped on the metro, went underground all the way to Sans Souci, I think that was the name of it. If you are interested in accommodation, then I did make another video last year about accommodation in Lyon, so definitely check that out. I'll pop that here. Yes, so to get started, the arrondissement system is something that is very common in France. A lot of you may be familiar with it from Paris. It's essentially a word meaning the district or a suburb, and in Lyon they have 9 arrondissements. So this video today I'm not going to talk about every single arrondissement just because I didn't go to them all, but I have quite a good feel for the city and I can give you a quick summary of my experience in each of those suburbs as I traveled through and spent time in various parts of the city, and it may help you decide where you would like to live. You can live anywhere in Lyon. It's a great town to get around in. They have the Vélo'Vie system, which is their like a bike collection depot where you can hire a bike and drop it all over the city. They also have the metro system, they have trams, you can walk there, and it's like a very flat and easy place to commute. But anyway, I will get started, and number one on the list is Vieux Lyon. So I am very, very fond about Vieux Lyon because that was my part of town when I was there. I really loved being there. It's the historic part of the city and it is very tourist heavy, so everyone who goes to Lyon will go to Vieux Lyon. If you don't, then that's crazy because it's beautiful, it's quintessentially French, old cobblestone streets, so much history. It's down the bottom of Fourvière, which is the hill that has the cathedral up the top, and there are so many artisan shops with all kinds of food, and the famous bouchon, which is the traditional French restaurants. They're just littered through the streets there, so it's great for all of those touristy first-do must-see things. So when you're walking down the streets of Vieux Lyon, it's like stepping back in time because you've got all the old buildings and they're all dotted with different colors, and the streets are all, you know, rickety, but it's really, really neat. I really loved it. Another feature of Vieux Lyon are the famous traboules, which is the spiral stairway system that connects from one street to the other. And my understanding is that these traboules were invented back in the times when Lyon was a busy, bustling merchant city that created or had lots of silk weaving manufacturing. So they created these underground tunnels underneath apartments and homes so that you could easily travel from one street to the other without having to walk around with a large bundle of goods, I suppose. Obviously, a must-do is to take the tram up to Fourvière to see the cathedral, and then in Vieux Lyon itself, there is also Cathédrale Saint-Jean, which is on Rue Saint-Jean, and that is a spectacular sight to see. So, a lot of history. Busy, lots of tourists generally. Obviously, I'm not sure right now in COVID times what it is like, but that is what it would be like if you chose to live in that part of town. Okay, so now we are moving from Vieux Lyon into the deuxième arrondissement, the second arrondissement. You imagine yourself walking over the bridge from Vieux Lyon over to Presqu'île, which is the center part of Lyon, and Presqu'île literally translates to almost an island. So you can kind of see here on the map that it almost looks like a strip of land deserted within these two rivers, when it actually is connected to the mainland, but it's just a little sort of peninsula that jets out into the water between the Rhône and the Saône River. Presqu'île is the main shopping district of Lyon, so a lot of the retail shops are there. You've got Place Bellecour, which is the town square, and then all around that you've got lots of shops and beautiful Haussmann designed architecture. It kind of looks like you're in Paris, and people do live there. There are plenty of residential areas in that part of town. It's really ideal if you want to be close to the shops. You've also got the metro there as well, and you're quite central, so it's a really good place to be if you want to be able to navigate around the city from a really central location. And then further down the Presqu'île on the very far side, you have this whole new development which is known as the Confluence, so the Confluence, which is essentially where the Rhône and the Saône rivers meet. And it's really interesting because down there it's so modern, it looks nothing like you'd imagine France to look like. They've got these crazy buildings with all this modern architecture, clean lines, and it's quite bizarre to see it, but it's really, really cool. And they have residential apartments down there as well. It's quite a hip new part of town. But I personally felt that it was quite far away from everything. As the further you move down towards the Confluence area, it gets a little bit harder to navigate around the central part of Lyon. So great for cool, hip, modern vibes. A little bit far away, in my opinion, but you know, whatever floats your boat. Okay, now I'm going to talk about the quatrième arrondissement, which is Croix Rousse and that general area. This area is sort of uphill. It looks over the city from a really cool perspective. There's amazing views up there. I would describe Croix Rousse as the art district of Lyon. It's quite quirky and artsy and really cool. They've got a lot of boutique shops. A lot of artists live there. I went to quite a few gigs around that part of town. Lots of live music. And they have really, really high windows in a lot of the buildings there, because back in the days of silk manufacturing, the canuts, who are the famous silk workers, used to have their workshops, and they needed to maximize the daylight that they could have to work around the clock, and so they had massive windows to allow lots of light to come in. What else can I tell you about Croix Rousse? Oh yes, Cour de Vorache, if I'm pronouncing it properly, is another traboule, which is those famous stairwells that would connect from one street to another. They have a very, very famous one in Croix Rousse, and it kind of has like these straight zigzaggy lines, and lots of people go there for the Instagram photos, and it's a really popular tourist destination. It is free to go as well, so definitely put that on the list when you are visiting that side of town. So now I'm going to talk about the sixième arrondissement, which is the sixth arrondissement of Lyon. I don't know a lot about this part of town, but I do know that the amazing, beautiful Parc de la Tête d'Or is located there, and it is a very swanky, bourgeoisie part of town, so mainly residential, and no one that I knew or that I had met when I was in Lyon lived there. It's not really a student part of town. It's quite an expensive area to live in. Some beautiful homes. It's definitely worth a walk around if you're there to have a look and see what properties look like. But the Parc de la Tête d'Or, which literally translates to Park of the Golden Head. I will look into that. I don't know why it is translated to that, but anyway. So the Parc de la Tête d'Or is this really amazing park, and at the entranceway you have the Porte des Enfants du Rhône, and it's this incredible wrought iron gate with gold tipped edges, and it's just ornate and so beautiful. You walk in these gates and there is a lake and people out on little paddle boats and beautiful gardens, and at the very far end of the park there is a zoo of all things, which is crazy. So when I was there, I'd go out there with friends and have picnics in the park, and then you could walk over to this zoo, which was free, and they had like orangutans and giraffes from memory and zebras and all kinds of things. It was really, really cool. So definitely go to the 6th arrondissement and check it out, because it's quite a spectacular sight to see. Now I'm going to talk about the 7th arrondissement, le 16e arrondissement, which is kind of, it's in the main university student area of town. So you've got Université Lyon 2, which is number 2. You have Lyon 3, which is number 3, where I went, le Manufacture de Tabac. If you want to see a video of le Manufacture de Tabac, I've done another video. I will put it here. The 7th arrondissement has quite a lot of different suburbs within it. I spent quite a bit of time in Jean Macé because I had a friend who was living in Garibaldi, the residence in my accommodation video that I did a tour on. Yeah, it's the university part of town. It's quite cheap in terms of accommodation. A lot of residential, a lot of young families live there. Plenty of the student residences are based there, probably purely because it's close to the various campuses that are in that part of town. The famous or infamous, I'm not sure, it's up to you, suburb of Guillotière is located there. And one thing I would say is just be careful in that part of town. Guillotière is a beautiful suburb because it sits right on the river, but it has been known for high rates of crime, and it's just somewhere that I would subtly warn you to not go walking about at night time. You just need to keep your wits about yourself if you're walking around there, particularly at night. But yes, that's the Guillotière. What else? The 7th arrondissement starts on the Berges du Rhône, and it's really cool because along the river there they've got this tiered seating, which is like almost like a grandstand sort of thing looking over the river. And in summer it's particularly busy down there. People go and buy a bottle of wine, they take a baguette and some cheese, fromage, and they just have a little picnic there. There are a couple of boats that have bars on them, which are quite cool. And there's actually also a swimming pool up that part of the river. And yeah, it's a really cool part of the city. It's it's really, really interesting. All over Lyon, when you think about it, they have a variety of activities and different things to do and see. So that is my whirlwind tour of Lyon through the arrondissement. I hope that this has given you something useful to guide your decision making as to where you would like to live when you move to the city. If you have any questions, I would be more than happy to answer them. Just send me a message or flick a comment down below. You can also chat to me through my Instagram or Facebook channels as well. Merci tout le monde. J'espère que vous allez bien à votre coin du monde. I hope that you're having a great day in your side of the world. And until next time, à bientôt. Au revoir.